I'm kind of annoyed with CSGO. It spends most of this year being completely neglected by Valve, causing its player base and community to lose faith, only for it to then get a year's worth of updates in a single sitting. So I'm splitting my coverage of Operation Riptide up into several parts, with this first one focusing on just the map changes. But first, if the game is now crashing for you, then try using the console command cl_force_preload0. Several times while making this video, I encountered a different bug where, upon loading a map, the frame rate would plummet to single digits. For me, lowering the anti-aliasing down to 2x did the trick, but it seems like something has changed with this game to have caused these problems. A bit surprisingly, Dust 2 has received a rather major change, even though the patch notes describe it as a slight visibility tweak. Well, no. It's a brand new extension which conveniently/inconveniently obstructs the sightline going all the way from T-spawn down to the CT crossing to B. And no, it isn't bangable. This update changes everything. Terrorists can no longer snipe CTs who are rushing to B unless the terrorists first hop over the wall. And even then, their visibility of the crossing isn't that great. Majorly nerfed. The wall has got taller, and thus harder to cleanly jump over, which will slightly hinder rushes down suicide until you get used to this. You can still boost onto the crates in this area, but you'll be cramped up there, and won't be able to just drop off the back the moment you find yourself in danger, so it's become a high-risk spot to be caught in now. You can just about see around this raised wall from this position, but you still can't see that much. You can peer down a bit of the left side of middle, but even this doesn't reach as far as the B tunnels. So I definitely say that this change has nerfed the terrorists at the start of the round, and gives CTs more chance of pulling off a cheeky rush into B tunnels from middle. However, its function changes later in the round, because this obstructed sightline will enable terrorists to be able to sneakily rotate through their spawn without being seen from middle. The only place CTs can really catch a glimpse of the rotation is from here, at which point they're pretty much up middle already, and are exposed from the side. So that's a huge change to one of the game's most beloved maps. I had another video that I was working on discussing stuff like this, so I'll leave my speculation for why this change has arrived so late to the game for another time. But I know that the map has fallen a bit out of favour in recent years, and the community has proposed numerous adjustments to it to address these shortcomings. Less than a week ago, in fact, there was a major discussion on the Global Offensive subreddit about this very issue, with some slightly more radical and less elegant solutions proposed to the sightline down middle. So this change might have been a very recent adjustment from Valve, simply to test the waters while Operation Riptide was underway, in order to distract people away from critiquing this particular change too greatly. The other noted change is to the back of Bombsite B. This doorway has been shifted around to the other side, to simplify the wall and to improve visibility for players approaching from the tunnel. It looks like the other details on the wall have also received a few minor improvements as well. But I don't trust Valve, so I flew about looking for other changes. They fixed the window at Long A, which would fade out far too soon, possibly allowing for players at long to peer into short to some degree, though I don't know if anybody ever found a way of gaining an advantage from doing this. But Valve likely fixed this months ago when I pointed it out, and have just forgotten to mention it in the patch notes now. And it looks like this very small vent on the side of the building has been made bigger. I don't think anybody was expecting to see changes being made to existing maps, or any at all, honestly. But the timing of this one is particularly unusual, what with all the pro teams being so busy training up and practicing on them for the next major, which isn't far away now. Now on to Inferno, which hasn't received such massive changes. I think the cube map used on the ground of A has shifted position somewhat, but other than that, I noticed nothing other than the documented changes to this corner. The see-through barred gate has been swapped for a simpler, brighter, and more readable white door model now, which in turn has simplified the lighting in this area to hopefully improve the visibility of players who have stood in this, admittedly still awkward, corner. Revised 1v1 layout might slightly understate how much the warm-up arenas have changed. The first time I saw the new one, I thought it was from the older version of Inferno. It's much more primitive and blockier looking now. It might play better, but it looks very plain in contrast to what came before. Ancient is the last official map to get official changes. Namely, the bomb sites have been extended to give terrorists more plant spots to choose from, like in this corner here on A, which is at least partially sheltered from both main CT approaches to the site. And B has been extended in all directions, and annoyingly the radar image still hasn't been updated to reflect this. Valve, please fix. There have been fixes to the bullet penetration and further optimizations, which, in my experience, means that the map has been stripped of its greenery. And sure enough, I found extensive cutbacks across the map, with numerous stone and plant props being removed in the name of frame rate, which I'm always very sad about. I think it's short-sighted to optimize a map in this way, when CSGO is already so easy to run and will only become more so as time goes on. But that's what's happened here. and the map has got its own 1v1 arenas, which, as usual, contain a bit of the indoor and outdoor scenery to give a brief summary of what the map looks like as a whole. Although not mentioned in the patch notes, Cache also got updated. Banana Gaming was ahead of me here, as usual, having already commented a few days ago over on the workshop page, detailing the changes, which include, I assume, quieter ambient sounds, better visibility, and more consistent architecture regardless of the graphics setting used. In practice, the only thing I could spot was this area of B, which now has fewer crossy bits further down. Diffuse maps Grind and Mocha have been swapped out for Basalt and Insertion 2, both of which I've covered before. Basalt is a diffuse map set in Iceland and was made for the MapCore 2019 competition, and is one of the more distinctive themes that I've seen recently, with bold, vivid colours against a dark background. And Insertion 2 isn't even a diffuse map, it's a hostage one with a twist, where the players get to choose their spawn points, and the map itself is much larger and more open than we're used to seeing from this game mode. The Danger Zone map, Frostbite, has been swapped out for County, which is a beautiful, sunny map, but with a few dark secrets. And while we've lost the Wingman maps, Pitstop and Calavera, we've gained in their place Ravine and Extraction. Ravine is a distinctive and cosy nighttime castle map, covered in a thick layer of snow. And Extraction is set in and around a luxury house by a lake, which I think every mapper has tried to make at some point, but perhaps not quite the quality on display here. I will say though, the map's borders hardly look like they could contain a gun-wielding player, comprising mostly of glass and low fencing. And hey look, I managed to escape from the play area here. Looks like the map's radar needs updating. So that's the map changes covered, but you can see that this is but a fraction of what rolled out with this update.